Yahoo!
I would say the toughest moment was when, before I became Foreign Minister, in 2004, when Lee Hsien Loong became Prime Minister, we found out that my youngest son had a relapse of his leukemia. He had had two rounds of chemo before. And the only possibility of him being safe was to go for a bone marrow transplant. We sent him to the best center in the US, St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. So that was the time when I became Foreign Minister. My whole family, my wife, my three other children, my mother-in-law, all uprooted to the US, to Memphis. They were there for 9 months. I was alone at home, running a new ministry. And I had to renovate the house because if he came back, and the chance was only 1 in 4 that he would survive, he would need a clean environment. So I renovated the house. So that period was quite a stressful period for me. I tried whenever I traveled to drop by to see him in the US. So I must have done it 6 times in those 9 months. 7 times in those 9 months. I didn't notice it, but people who saw me then said I looked a wreck. I must have. I would say that was the toughest period. It's a reality. I mean, microphones, cameras have become so tiny. We treat them as being ubiquitous. It means that if you think you have complete privacy, you're probably wrong. That we are determined, you can breach any private domain. So in that environment, it's as if we were living in a small kampong where walls are not soundproof and where people can eavesdrop. And that's the reality of the world that we live in. For a time, we thought that in an urban environment, we are anonymous, we have complete privacy. With the new technology, it will no longer be the case. Everything we said, every phone call we make, every message we send out, every email we send is being scooped up by intelligence agencies around the world and can be traced back. Maybe I need to. And can we fight it? Well, we can encrypt, but others can decrypt. You can think of... It's very difficult to think of ways to escape this, unless you completely disconnect yourself. But how do you disconnect yourself? Because you may disconnect yourself, but other people would not. So WikiLeaks is important in itself, but it's part of a much larger phenomenon sweeping the world, which we cannot roll back.
Yahoo!